actually achieved quite a significant milestone where HUL has got gender parity at least within its R&D division, within its R&D rank. So that in itself is a significant achievement and a significant milestone which deserves an applause. But, you know, what are you as a leader doing to ensure that you do achieve gender parity?
Yeah, thank you very much. You know, R&D, why we were talking about that, because generally in STEM education in India, or in R&D specifically, only 16% of it. And we have about 800 scientists and technologists, and under the leadership of Dr. Vibhav Sanskiri, who you saw in the afternoon today, we have got gender parity. Yeah, but it's not just R&D. Yeah, it's marketing, it's HR, it is legal. And let me tell you that amongst all our managerial ranks, we have reached 45% women, and in the next 2 years, we will be gender balanced. So it's not just about the management part. Now we are putting a focus on salespeople and factory. Yeah, we have set up a factory in Sumerpur where it is going to be gender balanced at the blue collar. So it can be done. We have to first start with the belief that women can do most jobs, if not all, with men. That's the starting question. The second is, you must believe in the business mix. Now look at us. 70% of people who consume the products of Hindustan Unilever, the decision makers are women. And in our company, we should represent our consumer base. Now if we aren't doing gender balance, or if we aren't bringing in equity, then we're doing disservice to the business. So there's a very strong business. Now, then what we have to do is, first is the culture, which is behavior and scale. And the stereotypical image that women have to be confined at home, which is an injustice we have done to women over centuries, that needs to be corrected. The second is hardware and software. That's so important. You know, I'll give you a very simple example. You know, Prabha and some of you all were talking about that there are certain points where women take a break. And I remember when I came in as a CEO about 10 years back, we did a lot of analytics and we found out a lot of women were leaving when either they were getting married or when they were becoming mothers. And the general perception was that because they've become mothers, they want to take a long leave or get away from work. I asked my team to go back and find out, are they still at home or are they working? We found out 80% of women had gone back to work. Then we reached out to them, did interviews, and we found out the reason was that when they would come back from maternity leave, we would give them soft jobs. Yeah, they've got baby at home, they won't be able to take the pressure of HUL. Let's give them soft jobs. And they didn't like it, because they thought they will lose in the race, and they didn't want this favor from the company. So we started a campaign, we will lose no mother. I used to follow up on every woman going on maternity leave and ensure that when she came back, she got as challenging a job as we gave Prabhanasi. And we stopped losing mothers. So you need to be very clearly, now when, say take a case of saleswomen in the field, our distributor says. Now in distributor's office, they aren't used to women working. So the first thing you need to do is ensure they have proper toilets for women. Yeah, if you don't do that, you won't be able to attract women. So it's culture very important. It is hardware, software, and we must remember something. It is not just diversity or gender balance. It is inclusiveness. Yeah, the old saying, it's not about inviting them to a party, but you have to make them dance. Yeah, you get them in, and then you expect them to behave like men, is wrong. Let them be comfortable in their skin. That is when they bring the best to the business. That's what we need to do.